Let's carry on by looking at functions with a variable number of keywords. Up to now, we've only allowed a certain number of keywords. We've limited what keywords can be passed. Now we can get beyond that by using these three dots. They are called a splat or ellipses. Now they might indicate the passing of no arguments, a single argument, or many arguments. So let's have a look at this. We have a function that we're going to define. I'm calling it func3, F-U-N-C-3. And I'm just using this word args. I could use anything I want, but dot, dot, dot. So there's my splat. And my function is going to do something useful. It's going to use the print command, and it's going to say, I can tell you how many arguments you passed. And then the dollar sign, remember, that's a placeholder. And whatever value Julia generates after this dollar sign, that's what's going to be passed, or whatever value is held in there. And I'm going to use this inbuilt length function, which is going to counts through a list. So it's going to tell me how many arguments I passed, args there, and it's going to return that. So let's create this function. You see a generic function with a single method. Now let's call it func3, and we pass no arguments whatsoever. And as you can well imagine, it says, I can tell you how many arguments you passed, 0. So let's pass this argument. So there's 1, 2, 3, 100,000. So func3, 100,000, but that's just a single argument. So it's telling me I passed one argument. Let's pass a single string, and I say, well, there's still just a single one. Now let's pass two arguments. You can see they're separated by a comma, Julia 3,3. Let's run that. And indeed, we have two arguments, and we see we don't even have to keep them of the same type. So I'm passing Julia is 1 in a million, and some two of them at least are just number values, and the rest are strings, and certainly it just counts through those with the length inbuilt length function. And we see there are 7 arguments, and I just created them. I just passed them, and my function was originally created with these splats. Or the splat, I should say. So let's get show something a bit more interesting. I'm creating a new function here, and I pass it a single. There is a single argument, and I'm going to call that argument string array. And what is it going to do? It's going to create a new variable inside of the function called string underscore items, and it's going to join. Use the inbuilt Julia function join, and join is going to take that string array, and it's going to concatenate it, sort of, with this comma and this space and space. And it's going to return this print line, I like, and then whatever was passed into the string items, remember, which was a join on this string array argument that I passed to the function food. Okay, let's see what happens. And I'm going to pass two arguments. But see here, I'm passing them as an array or a vector. Let's use the term array. So it's in these square brackets, and I have two values there in my array. So I'm calling this food function. Let's see what happens. And it says, I like Nutella and honey. So beautiful there. We see that it has joined the two arguments that I passed. Well, I actually passed the single argument, which was an array, and it contained two values. So what happens if I forget these square brackets of an array? So I'm going to forget these square brackets, and I'm just using a string. I'm just passing it a string. What is the join function going to do on a single string? Well, as you might have guessed it, it's going to do this, n, u, t. Okay, so that doesn't work. So to get around that, so that someone does not have to pass an array, we use the ellipses. So I didn't use args here, I used the word strings, SSS, strings, just to joke about that this is a splat and I can pass any number of things. So if I were to now create this function and pass this single argument called Nutella, it keeps it all together. So that join function is now going to see what I've passed as just a single argument, and the join function is not going to split the word up. But I can still do that, and now I can still pass more than one. Now it is going to be seen as three separate things. So I like Nutella honey and more Nutella. Good. Now, just for clarity's sake, we can really do something else. I'm going to say A, B, and then use a splat. And let's just return printing the values for A, B, and S to the screen. Let's just see what happens there. So let's have this function. Argues, and now look what happens. So 3 and 4, and then I'm passing all of this other stuff, 5, 6, 7, 8, and a string called Julia. And see what happens. The rest is actually passed as this tuple. So A was 3, B was 4, and then S, which was a splat, could take any number of values, but it treats it as this tuple with 5, 6, 7, 8, and Julia in there. So if I just call 3 and 4 and I pass nothing for the S, it's just going to return this empty tuple here. So let's have some a lot of fun. So I've got the semicolon in this function of mine, and then a splat. So this means that these are keywords. I can pass any number of keywords. Now remember the keywords, I'll just have to give them a name now as I pass them. So let's call this fun function, and I'm going to say var1 is Julia, var2 is language, and val1 equals 3. And lo and behold, look what gets returned, this one column array. And it's actually these a collection of a key and its value. So the key was var1 and its value was Julia. Key var2 was var2 and its value was language. And the key 3 was val1 and its value was 3. So more so, because I created them like this as a splat, and I gave them my own names, they actually what are called symbols with this colon sign in front. And this becomes very useful, especially with databases, or at least some data sets. And we'll certainly have a look at these symbols in a future lecture. Okay, so we've learned what splat is and how to create a long list of functions. In the next section, we're just going to have a quick look at flow control inside of a function. And then we're going to pass some arrays as function arguments.